help in. So I have a different view on how you guys can use gaming to just help the data science community. Yeah. So I'll be going through what's the scenario right now. These are the murders at OpenAI and DeepMind labs that recently occurred. Atari was broken down. Then Go was targeted. It was broken down. But somehow Dota 2 survives. Dota 2 doesn't give in into deep learning. Or let me just put it as reinforcement learning has not been able to conquer Dota 2 or even its players. Pretty amateur players are able to beat a reinforcement learning bot built in Dota 2. And why is that? I'll tell you why is that. This is from OpenAI. Direct, you can go to the link. They started this April 16 training a bot that uses reinforcement learning to win over a championship that is like millions of dollars. That happens to be the premier of gaming. So they started on April 16 and it took them around 2 or 3, maybe more, 4 months to make a bot that could beat a good amateur player with reinforcement learning. But still the player that was the champion, the recent champion, they could not beat. Now, why is that? We were told that reinforcement learning was the epitome of deep learning, right? Let me talk about a different approach. I'll tell you the drawbacks of reinforcement learning, but let me talk about something that I came up with. This is a basic idea of classification. How many of you are into data science or deep learning or machine learning? Any? Most of you guys have built a model. So basically, a classification model works like it conventionally takes in an image, a data set of image. You train it on some labels. And it's done in a closed compiled environment. And then you, in batch sizes, give your test data in and predict the scores, or predict the label. You can take this forward into a real-time classification and contextual learning, right? What this is what I did is, I had to make a real-time agent. I had to make a real-time agent. A real-time agent that could learn actions, that could classify actions, what's coming up next. See, conventionally what happens is, if it's a dog or a cat, you build a model that says it's a dog or a cat, right? But what if a car is passing by and you are in the seat of a car and a dog is there in your view, right? Where do you go, left or right? You should brake or accelerate. So this is a real-time classification. Not making predictive sessions through code. We are not making predictive sessions through code. But what we are doing is we are inputting every frame, and according to it, there is a prediction that is encoded in as labels, right? For a given frame, like a car's first-person view in a car. And I give in go left or go right. If you see a dog, go left. If you see a cat, go right. Has no environment preloaded in the model. See, reinforcement learning fails as it has an environment preloaded in the model. Dota 2 is a very big game. We saw a 2D model, a car that was going up the hill that was in 2D. Right? You cannot solve real life problems as of now because it's not permittable by the GPUs that we are using in the current age. So it has no environment preloaded in the model. We are just inputting the images. Occupies lesser VRAM than in reinforcement learning. Obviously, VRAM is deallocated because there's no environment, right? In most practical cases, agent, I won't say most practical cases is a typo, but let me say that in most cases, the imagery data is the prominent source of agent, right? See, what you see is very prominent, And then comes the sensor that reinforces what action should you take. So it has a faster training, obviously, because lesser load. Still waiting. Okay, so I made an AI pilot. Please don't call it an autopilot. I get hurt. It's an AI pilot that flies a plane, right? Most of the people are doing research in self-driving cars and self-driving like utility objects, anything that pushes itself automatically. So I made a self-driving plane, and here's a demo. Like this was done in a GTA 5, like it is probably done in a game. I'll reference this later as to why I'm using a simulated environment and why that, like, I thought the simulated environment test cases are really bad because that does not work in the real world, but I'll come up with a solution later. Now it's disconnected. Okay. Okay. So the first one was takeoff. This is landing, and I don't know why it's crashing, but wait. Let me show you in the slides, right? Maybe that'll work. So what you can see is this is a frame, and according to every frame that the model is seeing, it's giving an output as to what action it should take. Okay. Like, let me. So you can see there are 8 outputs for acceleration, brake, pitch, yaw, roll, everything you can do with the plane. And this is a disclaimer, this is doing by itself. Passes. This is a landing example. This is a vanilla model, and you all can do it on your laptops. It's so simple. It requires like 230 or 300 MB of VRAM, right? Everybody has that. You should have an NVIDIA GPU. That's just the prerequisite. This model was trained on AlexNet with, let me get into the model while it's landing. This is AlexNet, which is 2012 vanilla, just the basic neural net you could get, convolutional neural net you could get, with the LSTM layer at the top, just that. This landing example is very superior to the last one, if I let it through. This is a convolutional LSTM with attention-based learning involved, which is a whole other beast. I won't get into now, but you can see the result. This is a really smooth landing, and it knows now where the runway is and how to taxi through the runway. Yeah, keyword was untouched. So why a game? Like, first let me get to the model. It's a YOLO model. You only look once. The network has only, it has only a chance to look at the frame and make out the movement prediction. Everything is happening real time. It sees an image in real time. It predicts in real time. It takes the action in real time. From the collection of the frame right to where the model predicts is in real time. Behavior, behavioral cloning plus semi-reinforced cost function. I won't get into this, but let me just say behavioral cloning is, I was training the model, so it was mimicking my behavior, but a semi-reinforced cost function made it better than how I could fly a plane. Okay, so solving the data collection problem. You just saw a simulator, right? How could I apply this to a real world problem? Maybe have a camera on a plane and make it fly. I cannot use the same model. It's been trained in a simulator that looks something and that is something. Real time, it's a whole another scenario. The clouds look different. Everything looks different, right? So here comes the part two of my project. First, let me get through the data set problem. What were the problems? No tailor-made data set is available that fits your test case. So if you say that we change the data set, you are thrown out. You collect the data set from various points, data engineer it, and put it in your model, fit your model. So I came up with a solution that you can make your own data. Let's see how. Another problem is with real world data set, if you want to generate it, it will cost a fortune. Like if you are Bill Gates or something, or maybe this guy that we'll see up here, handling of proprietary data will probably get you into places such as, okay. So if you are not so rich, you can generate data on your laptop. Now how to generate real world data on your laptop? So using cycle GANs for style transferring and GTA 5 image to a real world image made it possible. Let me give you a demo of, these are big words, a demo would clear it up. You can, as you can see, the swipe through, like this part is the actual world conversion, and the that side, this is GTA 5. That is GTA 5, this is the conversion using GANs. So you can convert the data from your simulator to a real world looking, like city looking data. And maybe use it. This is the hypothesis, by the way, everything is in deep learning. This is a day and night conversion. Not only you can do like in daytime, we probably have cars running through in Waymo or Tesla that records data daytime. We can use that data we already have, or maybe in simulator generation, and use it to have nighttime data. Can you see how, like, while sitting at your laptop, you can generate something that Tesla is doing with millions of cars it's running? So play video games and help the AI community thrive. Data everywhere. I have some bragging rights. If you know Harrison Kinsley, if anybody knows who's Harrison Kinsley, Sendex, like I got a retweet from him while I did this project. There's some bonus content, like we have time, right? I thought I wouldn't have some time, but it's a cool video. Like this is nothing related to my model, I just wanted to show this up. This is a CPU versus GPU testing, like how a CPU works and how a GPU works, if that's not clear enough for deep learning and maybe parallel and sequencer tasks. This is how CPU prints an image. and this is a GPU. So this is how a GPU prints an image. And this is why you can do things real time with the GPU. Thank you. Any questions?